Hello and welcome to In Depth. I am Smriti Rastogi. China is struggling to contain the spread of a new virus that has claimed at least 6 lives so far since 31st December. Almost 300 people have been hospitalized. Worryingly enough, doctors have confirmed that the infection is spreading rapidly among humans. The outbreak has triggered memories of SARS, or severe acute respiratory syndrome. It originated in China in 2002. By 2003, it infected more than 8,000 people and killed 774 in a pandemic that ripped through Asia. The present virus is called the coronavirus. It was first detected in Wuhan city that has cancelled the upcoming Lunar New Year celebrations, where hundreds of thousands of people were expected to attend. Tour agencies have also been banned from taking groups out of Wuhan, even as Chinese President Xi Jinping has ordered resolute efforts to curb the spread of the virus since Monday. With one patient infecting as many as 14 medical staff in just one hospital, Chinese doctors believe that disease is spreading far more easily than it was thought previously. On In Depth today, we try to understand what is this coronavirus, the potential for its further spread, and other vital facts associated with it. China is racing against time to contain the spread of a new virus that has left at least 6 people dead ahead of the Lunar New Year celebrations that attracts millions of people back to their homeland. The coronavirus has infected almost 300 people, with most cases reported in Wuhan, that later spread to Beijing, Shanghai and Guangdong. Wuhan has announced a series of new measures to tackle the spread of the disease, including the cancellation of upcoming Lunar New Year celebrations.
The novel coronavirus is spreading its deadly tentacles in China and abroad. All of the fatalities have been in Wuhan, the central Chinese city which has detected most cases of pneumonia caused by the new coronavirus. After originating in a seafood market in Wuhan, the outbreak is now spreading. Chinese news agency Xinhua reported as of 6 p.m. on 20th January that 224 cases of pneumonia caused by the 2019 NCOV have been reported. 217 cases have been confirmed, out of which 198 cases have been from Wuhan. 14 cases have been reported in Guangdong province, 5 in Beijing. 15 medical workers have also tested positive for the virus, according to the Wuhan Municipal Health Commission. 4 cases have also been confirmed overseas among Chinese travelers, 1 in Japan, 2 in Thailand and 1 in South Korea.
See, the coronavirus, to the best of our knowledge, there are 6 coronaviruses. This one would be the 7th, which reported few months back in China. The symptoms are just like your flu type symptoms, with fever and respiratory symptoms, breathlessness, etc. Now few more cases are reported from other countries also, like Japan, Korea.
Common signs of infection include respiratory symptoms, fever, cough, shortness of breath and breathing difficulties. In more severe cases, infection can cause pneumonia, severe acute respiratory syndrome, kidney failure and even death. The World Health Organization said that its China country office was informed of cases of pneumonia of unknown etiology detected in Wuhan city on 31st December. A novel coronavirus was identified as the causative virus by the Chinese authorities on 7th January. On 10th January, the WHO published a set of guidelines for all countries. This includes monitoring for sick people, testing samples, treatment and control of virus, and communicating with the public about this new virus. The WHO has also convened an emergency meeting this week to discuss the spread of the Wuhan virus.
中方将会应世卫组织的邀请，与其他受疫情影响的国家一道，参加国际卫生条例突发事件委员会会议，与会各国世卫组织以及有关的专家，将在会上分享疫情信息，并对疫情进行科学研判。
With the Lunar New Year approaching, the Chinese government is taking all measures for prevention and control of the new strain of the coronavirus. Chinese President Xi Jinping has instructed government departments to promptly release information on the virus and make all-out efforts to treat patients.
我这里能告诉你，就是为了应对武汉肺炎疫情，中方采取了严密的措施。 也做了全面的部署，我们将坚决遏制疫情蔓延的势头。中方愿意继续深化国际合作，与国际社会携手应对疫情，共同维护地区和全球的卫生安全。
Zhang Nanshan, the head of the National Health Commission of China, confirmed that the new coronavirus spreads by human-to-human transmission. However, he tried to allay fears of a rerun of the severe acute respiratory syndrome or SARS outbreak that killed nearly 800 people across the world and was caused by a coronavirus, though a different strain.
Everybody who has ever dealt with SARS or MERS, for that matter, know that the critical issue in controlling a coronavirus novel emerging pathogen epidemic is to make sure that the super spreading events that we've seen during SARS at Ward 8A, Prince of Wales Hospital, Amoy Gardens, or MERS in, say, the Seoul Hospital. So it is absolutely critical that public health authorities recognize a super spreading event in the very earliest stages before it goes absolutely explosive.
Concerned about a global outbreak similar to SARS, many countries have adopted screening measures for travelers arriving from China, especially those from Wuhan. Australia, Japan, and South Korea have increased airport screenings. At least three U.S. airports have started screening of incoming airline passengers from central China. With human-to-human transmission confirmed, the Chinese government is scrambling to control the spread of the coronavirus that is threatening to spread further and turn into an epidemic during the Lunar New Year rush when millions travel back home to China for the holiday. With inputs from Kunal Singh, Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
While even the common cold is caused by a strain of the coronavirus, the novel strain of the virus can cause much more severe and deadlier symptoms. What started out as just a cold could develop into pneumonia and bronchitis. The Middle East Respiratory Syndrome and the Severe Acute Respiratory Syndrome is also caused by the strains of the coronavirus. Let us now look at the symptoms this virus can bring on and how to prevent catching an infection.
The coronavirus can make people sick, usually with a mild to moderate upper respiratory tract illness, which can be similar to a common cold. Symptoms include a runny nose, cough, sore throat, possibly a headache, and maybe a fever lasting for a couple of days. But in people with a weakened immune system, especially the elderly and the very young, the virus could be more serious. In these groups, the virus could cause a lower and much more serious respiratory tract illness like pneumonia or bronchitis.
So coronaviruses typically cause respiratory symptoms, so we recommend basic hand hygiene such as washing your hands with soap and water, and respiratory hygiene such as when you sneeze, sneezing into your elbow.
The new discovery comes in the wake of the SARS or Severe Acute Respiratory Syndrome outbreak in 2003 and the first human detection of MERS-CoV or the Middle East Respiratory Syndrome coronavirus in 2012. SARS and MERS are two of the deadly human coronaviruses. The Middle East Respiratory Syndrome, also known as the MERS virus, was first reported in the Middle East in 2012 and also causes respiratory problems, but those symptoms are much more severe. It is deadly for 3 to 4 out of every 10 patients that get infected. The severe acute respiratory syndrome, also known as SARS, is the other coronavirus that can cause more severe symptoms. SARS causes respiratory problems but can also cause diarrhea, fatigue, shortness of breath, respiratory distress, and kidney failure. Depending on the patient's age, the death rate with SARS can range from 0 to 50% of the cases, with older people being the most vulnerable.
Coronaviruses are a family of viruses that range from the common cold to MERS coronavirus, which is Middle East Respiratory Syndrome coronavirus, and SARS, Severe Acute Respiratory Syndrome coronavirus. Coronaviruses are circulating in animals, and some of these coronaviruses have the capability of transmitting between animals and humans. We call that a spillover.
With coronavirus being a zoonotic virus, it spreads from human contact with animals. Once it reaches humans, it can spread fast, as it often spreads when someone comes into contact with the infected person's secretions. Depending on how virulent the virus is, a cough, sneeze, or a handshake can cause exposure. The virus can also be transmitted by touching something an infected person has touched and then touching your mouth, nose, or eyes. Caregivers can sometimes be exposed by handling a patient's waste. There is no specific treatment for the coronavirus. Doctors can relieve symptoms by prescribing pain or fever medication, but most of the time, symptoms will go away on their own. A room humidifier or a hot shower can help with a sore throat or cough. If infected, drink plenty of fluids, get rest, and sleep as much as possible. However, if the symptoms feel worse than a common cold, it's important to see the doctor.
Ways to protect yourself against a potential animal source would be to avoid unnecessary, unprotected contact with live animals and to make sure that you wash your hands thoroughly after contact with an animal, and also to make sure that your meat is cooked thoroughly before consuming.
Avoid contact with any symptomatics. And if a person is, suppose, coming from China, and if he or she has developed this type of symptom, then they must restrict themselves if they want to prevent this infection to others. So, and immediately report to a health facility.
There is no vaccine to protect against this family of viruses, at least not yet. But you may be able to reduce your risk of infection by avoiding people who are sick. With inputs from Kunal Singh, Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
And with that, we'll slip into a very quick break. Stay with us.
Watch The Big Picture with me, Frank Rousen Pereira, at 9:30 p.m.
Tales that inspire. Stories of social change. A salute to diversity. Promoting public discourse. Events that motivate. Inspiring the innovative spirit. Watch Rajya Sabha television documentaries.
Welcome back after the break. Recently, the World Health Organization confirmed that with the changing environment, new diseases are emerging and health organizations are failing to find cures in time. It is extremely important to control these diseases in time before they become an epidemic. Detection of novel coronavirus in China and its neighboring countries has once again turned the focus on major public health problems caused due to zoonotic diseases, that is, an infection that spreads from animals to humans.
Oh.
On December 31st, 2019, World Health Organization's head office in China was informed about cases of pneumonia with an unknown cause detected in China's Wuhan city. 7 days later, on January 7th this year, a novel coronavirus was identified as the cause virus by Chinese authorities. Denoted 2019 NCOV by the WHO, it is now also known as the Wuhan coronavirus, Wuhan seafood market pneumonia virus, and the Wuhan pneumonia. A novel coronavirus is a new strain that has not been previously identified in humans. Coronaviruses are a large family of viruses that cause illness ranging from the common cold to more severe diseases like the Middle East Respiratory Syndrome and Severe Acute Respiratory Syndrome. Common signs of infection include respiratory symptoms, fever, cough, shortness of breath, and breathing difficulties. In more severe cases, infection can cause pneumonia, severe acute respiratory syndrome, kidney failure, and even death. Coronaviruses are zoonotic, meaning they are transmitted between animals and people. Zoonotic diseases are caused by harmful germs like viruses, bacteria, parasites, and fungi. These infections can be transmitted through bats, bugs, cats, fleas, flies, monkeys, pigs, horses, rabbits, mice, goats, mosquitoes, and even humans. According to the World Health Organization, animal flu, bird flu, cat scratch fever, dengue, encephalitis from ticks, hepatitis E, Lyme disease, malaria, plague, and rabies are some examples of zoonotic diseases. There is now a much greater risk of zoonoses or infectious diseases that can be transmitted between domestic and wild animals and humans.
Usually zoonotic disease, the primarily they infect animals. So animals are reservoir of all the zoonotic diseases, like your either Nipah virus or your rabies, which is transmitted from dog bite. Actually, these are the neglected diseases. So we also call neglected tropical diseases.
Global warming and changing lifestyles are seen as a reason for the spread of infections in humans. These and many such diseases have existed for a long time, but they are now developing resistance to medicines, and medical science seems to be lagging far behind in finding cures for them. Nipah and Ebola are zoonotic diseases which have much higher chance of turning into an epidemic. There are also allegations that drug companies often promote such diseases for business motives. The WHO panel will meet in Geneva on Wednesday to determine whether to declare the outbreak an international public health emergency, a rare move only used for the gravest epidemics. This after reports confirm that the new virus has reached three other Asian countries apart from China. With inputs from Kunal Singh, Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
Virus outbreaks are not uncommon in the world. Here's a look at some of the deadly viruses that have caused pandemics in different regions of the world down the years.
Viruses have been the cause of many epidemics for the past several centuries, triggering panic among people. The devastating viral pandemics that occurred in the 18th century confirmed fears of its spread by both humans and animals. While most viruses are dangerous, some may even be fatal. Marburg virus is considered to be the deadliest one. It is named after a small and idyllic town on the river Lahn. The Marburg virus is a hemorrhagic fever virus which causes convulsions and bleeding of mucous membranes, skin, and organs. It has a fatality rate of 90%. Kasnur forest virus is another deadly virus that was discovered in the southwestern coast of India in 1955. Scientists say it is difficult to determine any carriers of the virus. People infected with this virus suffer from high fever, strong headaches, and muscle pain, which can cause bleedings. For the past few years, Ebola has earned a reputation for being the killer virus. There are five strains of the Ebola virus, each named after countries and regions in Africa: Zaire, Sudan, Thai Forest, Bundibugyo, and Restone. The Zaire Ebola virus is the deadliest, with a mortality rate of 90%. The spread of bird flu also triggers panic, with a mortality rate of 70% of the H5N1 strain. This virus is contracted through direct contact with poultry, and hence mostly it infects those who work at the poultry farms or live in the vicinity. The Hanta virus is also one of the deadliest viruses across the world. It is named after a river where American soldiers were first believed to have been infected with the Hanta virus during the Korean War in 1950. Symptoms include lung disease, fever, and kidney failure. The Lassa virus is transmitted by rodents. The virus occurs in a specific region like Western Africa and can reoccur in that region at any time. As per scientists, 15% rodents in Western Africa carry the virus. The Argentine Junin virus is associated with hemorrhagic fever. Infected people suffer from tissue inflammation, sepsis, and skin bleeding. The disease is rarely detected in the initial days, as the symptoms appear to be common. The Bacupo virus is the cause of Bolivian hemorrhagic fever, also known as black typhus or outdoor fever. It causes high fever, often accompanied by heavy bleedings. The virus is carried by the rodents and it spreads from human to human. The Crimean-Congo virus is a type of viral hemorrhagic fever transmitted by ticks. Its symptoms include fever, muscle pains, headache, vomiting, diarrhea, and bleeding into the skin. A constant threat, the fear of dengue epidemic spreads panic in India year after year. The virus is transmitted by mosquitoes and affects between 50 and 100 million people a year, with most cases occurring in tropical areas. The World Health Organization and other such institutions try to make people aware about the dangers of the virus outbreaks, thereby trying to contain the spread of the viruses and their impact. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
And that's all we have for you in this edition of In Depth. We will be back same time tomorrow with a focus on another key subject. You can also watch our program online on YouTube. Suggestions and feedback about the program are welcome. Thank you for watching.